So let us now discuss that how we can create our first Spring Boot application, and then we will discuss about creation of RESTful APIs, and we will also see that how we can test our APIs by using browser and by using Postman. So for developing our Spring Boot application, I am using an Spring Tool Suite or STS. So let us see that how we can create our first Spring Boot application. So for creating our application, we have to go to File, then New. And under New, we are having an Spring Starter project. So by using an Spring Starter, we can quickly create our Spring Boot application. So here we need to give the name of our application, and we are creating a Maven project. And here we have to select the Java version, and here you have to provide the group name, and this is the artifact ID, and here you can provide the package name. Now you have to click Next. Now using this particular section, you can add various dependencies to your project. So friends, for developing Spring REST or Spring MVC application, we need to add Spring Web dependencies. So by typing web, you can see that we are having an Spring Web option. So in description, you can see that it is used for developing a RESTful application along with the features of Spring MVC. And one good thing about creating a RESTful application by using Spring Boot is that we don't have to add an external server. An Apache Tomcat server is by default embedded inside Spring Boot container. So here I am selecting an Spring Web. And if you have to add the dependencies for your database, then you can simply type KDBC and you will get an option to add the dependencies for different type of servers. So whether you are using an Oracle database for your application, or if you're using a Postgres or MySQL database, then you can simply add the dependencies by just selecting the available options. And if you don't want to add an external database, then you can also use an internal database or an embedded database which is provided by Spring Boot, that is an H2 database. So after selecting all the dependencies, you can click Next and then Finish. So after clicking Finish, you can see that an Spring Boot application is developed for us. So here you can see that the project structure is already there. So this is the name which we have provided for our package, that is com.programmingwithchetan.springboot. And here we are having a resource folder. So inside the source folder, we can place an static content. And under the source, we are having one of the very important file, that is application properties. So by using this application.properties file, we can provide various important properties that is required for our Spring Boot application. For example, if you want to provide the port number for your server, then you can simply use a property that is server.port, and you can simply provide the port number on which your server will listen. So inside this application.properties file, we can define all the properties which is required for our project, whether it is a server address or the server port number, or if you want to provide your database name, the URL of your database, or the port number of your database, or if you want to define any custom properties, then you can simply use this application.properties file. Then we are having one more package which is used for testing our application. And here you can notice one thing, that we have not added any external JRE or any Maven dependencies. We have simply selected the dependencies which we need for our project. And you can see that all the dependencies are automatically added by Spring Boot Starter project. So here you can see that all the Spring dependencies are there along with an Spring Boot Starter. Then Log4j dependencies are there. Then this JSON dependency is there, which is used for various important annotations along with supporting different formats like JSON. And here you can see that we are having an Tomcat dependencies. So there is no need of adding any external server, and our Spring Boot is providing an embedded server, that is Tomcat. Similarly, here you can see that our Spring Web Jar is there, which is used for Spring MVC and for developing Spring RESTful web services. Along with that, you can also see that it has downloaded and JUnits, that is used for testing purpose. So you can see that how simply we can add all the dependencies in Spring Boot application. So we don't have to worry about adding all these dependencies one by one. We just have to select the option, and Spring Boot will add all these dependencies in our project. And here you can see that this is again one of the very important files, that is pom.xml. So by watching this tutorial, you can see that we are also learning about a Maven project. So this pom.xml is one of the very important file for our application. So here you can see that this is the group ID which we have provided, and this is the name of our application. and this is the artifact ID which we have provided initially while developing our application, and this is the Java version which we have selected while creating our project. And here you can see that it has automatically added all the dependencies for Spring Boot Starter Web, and this is for S2 database, which is an internal database provided by Spring Boot. And it has also added one more dependency, that is Spring Boot Starter Test, which is used to write test cases or to test our application. So my dear friends, this is the basic structure of our Spring Boot application.